What was that?
Hey. Perfect. First drive, eh?
Yeah.
That Yo, that was insane. That sounded so good.
It sounds rowdy.
Damn, son. So excited.
It works.
So excited.
That's sick. Oh my god, I can't wait to get this fixed.
All right, we are taking the car to Dyno Tune to get the transmission checked out.
I guess you've never seen underneath the car.
I have
before,
not.
Right?
I
already looked at it.
Everything's
the car was red before?
Yeah.
Yeah.
The only thing I'm paying is
it's
the bottom.
Everything.
So
I already looked at everything.
Yeah.
No leaks.
Oh, geez.
But your tranny is. So I'm just going to drop the tranny. It looks like the clutch fork's broken.
Yeah, I figured. Oh, yeah. Eh?
It's broken.
Right.
It wouldn't be able to wiggle like that. So.
Yeah.
Just kind of just put the clutch fork in, get her going.
Yeah, pretty much like, I guess whatever is broken when you pull it out.
The car's very clean.
Just want to check.
I've had two GDSMs, I jack from here, and
yeah,
the car doesn't go
they
up.
Fall through, eh?
The hoist just goes through the fucking car, bro. Yeah,
yeah,
this car is very, very clean.
This one, it's original GSX, right?
Yeah.
It's
yeah.
Not converted.
No. Yeah.
Nice part, right?
Thank you, yeah, man.
I'm going to drain that anyways. It
yeah.
Looks like, usually.
Oh, it just looks like it leaks
from
the
car. It's
just
a washer, yeah, you know what I mean? Because
okay.
It's not tight.
Okay,
so if
cool.
I'm driving the car just from the wind and stuff, it'll start to.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Go everywhere there.
Okay.
I already kind of went over the car.
Okay.
That's all it is.
Okay, sounds good, man. Yeah, I just wanted to.
Yeah, this little wet over here. It could be your rack is leaking.
Yeah.
Again, rack is like just a rack.
Yeah.
Like that. Yeah. Or it just could be. So what I'll do is I'll clean it up.
Yeah, and see if
and
it comes
out.
Thanks. I guess you're not used to seeing them this clean. No, right? 1Gs are cleaner usually? I guess more of the purest care.
I've been using them for 25 years. So
yeah.
I hate
it. Really? I noticed there's only one fan and it's just stuck onto the radiator. It's just, I heard the Mitsubishi motor.
Mitsubishi motor one, it's like a 1500.
Someone referred the small 10 inch, I think. Because they're slimmer?
No, don't put a slimmer fan, just thicker fan. As you can. The
just,
fan is
this
the
is good. Here, the wastegate's going to be in the way, so I have to figure out something
the
later.
Supposed to be here.
Oh, really? Only one fan is good?
That fan is perfect.
Okay. You see how it's mounted? It's stuck in the fins, and
yeah,
then.
That's the way we always do it.
Oh, really? Eh?
Yeah, every car we do.
Oh,
like that, yeah.
Okay.
You have to put it through the fin, this is a rod stand.
This is my first DSM, so I'm learning the ways, yeah, clearly.
Well, you're in the right spot. I've been playing with these cars for the longest.
Yeah.
Canada, you know what I mean? So
okay.
You can come look at my fans.
Sure. This thing ran, what did this run? 9 something?
92. So
oh.
The same ball fan right there.
Beauty.
And I just stuck I literally don't even need that fan.
Okay.
I just put it there. Now if you put a fan on this side of the car,
yeah,
it has to be on all the time. The reason why is going to melt now.
From the downpipe?
If it's not on, those $20 fans, they just melt. So it's got to be, that one fan you have is as big as this.
Blows
like 1600 CFM.
Yeah. Okay. Cool. Hey, we got the little dump tube here. Huh. No leaks, luckily. What's going on this? This is wiring for something. What I liked about this is like it seemed like he was using quality parts and stuff, or at least we're on it. So I'm like,
yeah.
It wasn't one of the typical DSMs that I just cheaped out on.
It's good. Dump tube's in a good spot too.
Yeah.
There's no leaks.
My first turbo car.
Is it?
Yeah.
The DSM, you'll always be fixing it.
Yeah. And tires. I get some wheels, I don't know. I like the wheels actually. They're like pretty
nice.
Nice.
And the car's clean.
Like I always, you know.
Rims are nice.
Are these OEM rims or?
Yeah, they're
NK
legal rims.
Okay.
I
love the blue touch. Okay.
OEM rims, but it makes a more reliable car.
Oh yeah?
Yeah, because when the idle control motor burns out in these cars, which it does every few years, it's going to take out your ECU with it.
What? Really?
Yes, that's why we remove it, yes.
Oh, that's so
I
weird.
I haven't had an idle control motor in 18 years in this car. I haven't had an ECU problem since.
I wonder what these are, actually. These are 235-40s. 18s, okay, so that's decent. I mean, obviously, I'd run 18s, and maybe a 255. giveaway car, right? I've seen that. Yeah.
Yeah, I've seen that.
Gotta get the new radiator in there. It's sweating. We just went through the whole motor and stuff, right? I want to make sure all everything's clean.
We got a nice collection of cars here. God dang, man. This Evo is beautiful. Look at this. That is clean. Ooh, look at those door panels. Got the rally. Okay, that's really cool. Wrapped it with this whole galaxy vibe, man. That's very nice. Got the AM boost gauge in the cluster. That's really sick. Got a really cool Genesis, nice gold intercooler. And that dump tube. Oh my god, the RPF1s look so good on this. It looks 17s? Yeah. That's very clean, man. Damn. I wouldn't mind that. Look at my dutty boy. We got this guy here boosting north. They got that giveaway car.
You guys are working on their giveaway car. At least they're getting it worked on here. It's not gonna be cheap, you know? So, as you saw in the video, Reza thinks it's a super clean car. He repeated it like 5-10 times. It was awesome. I'm really happy with how it actually is. Really clean. He only pointed out a couple of things, which is why I sent it there anyway. So, transmission's gonna get pulled and probably going to replace the clutch fork and maybe the release bearing if it needs to be replaced, and clutch if it needs to be replaced. Clutch is fine, so I think we're good on that part. But yeah, really excited to finally get it on the road. Winter's gonna be done here soon, so I'll have it out then. I don't think I can put this car through our winters. I think it's just too rare and in too good of a condition to winter drive it. Only reason is the salt, otherwise I'd love to drive this in the snow. Oh my god. Maybe if like there's a fresh snow out, I can do some donuts or something. But if you enjoyed this car, want to see more DSM content, let me know by liking the video and hit the subscribe button, because I would love to hit 600 followers soon and hopefully keep going to 1,000. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.